G7 between President Biden and Russia's Vladimir Putin. Their first meeting since President Biden took office, and certainly the president's biggest test yet on the world stage. Tonight, what we have learned here, who will be in that room, how long this will go. They're actually expecting their meeting to last from 4 to 5 hours. This will all begin around 7 a.m. Eastern time tomorrow morning, U.S. time, about early in the afternoon here in Geneva. And of course, that key question, how will the U.S., how will President Biden measure success? The president arriving here in Geneva, the seventh day of his trip after the G7 summit, the NATO summit, and meetings with other European leaders. Tonight, the president telling reporters he is ready. And we're learning more from the White House on how the president prepared for this. All the leaders will hold their summit here at a public park in a sprawling chateau called Villa Lagrange, with views of Lake Geneva. And afterward, we have learned there will not be a joint news conference, unlike former President Trump standing side by side with the president, telling the world that people need to move over his own U.S. intelligence community on meddling in our elections. President Biden in this summit will likely talk about election interference, also about cyber attacks on our government, and then those Russian-based attacks on our infrastructure affecting gas prices and the U.S. meat supply. And of course, that's just the beginning. The Russians have brought up the idea of a prisoner swap. Two former Marines are being held in Russia. President Biden, who once said he did not believe Putin had a soul, telling our Cecilia Vega coming into this summit that Putin is a worthy adversary. So our chief White House correspondent, Cecilia Vega, leading us off again tonight, right here in Geneva.
On the eve of his high-stakes summit with the man he's called a killer, tonight, President Biden sounding confident. Sources telling ABC News the president has been preparing for weeks, receiving briefings at least once a day. The summit, expected to last 4 to 5 hours, first just President Biden and Vladimir Putin, plus Secretary of State Antony Blinken and his Russian counterpart. Later, senior aides brought in.
I'm going to make clear, President Putin, that there are areas where we can cooperate if he chooses.
On the agenda, Putin's election meddling, human rights, and cyber attacks, including one that threatened to disrupt the U.S. meat supply and another that triggered gas shortages and price hikes along the East Coast. Among those briefing the president, Russia expert Fiona Hill, who served in the Trump administration and testified in the impeachment trial. She was in the room for that now infamous moment when President Trump publicly sided with Putin over his own intelligence community.
He just said it's not Russia. I will say this, I don't see any reason why it would be. I will tell you that President Putin was extremely strong and powerful in his denial today.
Hill describing her reaction in the BBC documentary, Trump Takes on the World.
My initial thought was just, how can I end this? I literally did have in my mind the idea of faking some kind of medical emergency and throwing myself backwards with a loud, blood-curdling scream into the media.
President Biden says the last thing he wants in Geneva is a spectacle.
This is not a contest about who can do better in front of a press conference or try to embarrass him. It's about making myself very clear what the conditions are to get a better relationship are with Russia.
The last time the two men met, then Vice President Biden told Putin he had no soul. Now, President Biden telling me he knows exactly what he's walking into.
He's bright, he's tough, and I have found that he is a, as they say, when he used to play ball, a worthy adversary.
And Cecilia Vega joins us tonight from Geneva. And Cecilia, former President Trump and Vladimir Putin, as we remember, they met alone with just translators in the room. But that's not going to happen this time.
It's not expected to happen, David. And that's no surprise. What President Trump did was almost unheard of. But look, the Biden team says they are leaving some flexibility in that schedule tomorrow. So not every detail of the day is planned out. We do know the one thing that at this point is not on the schedule. The two men are not expected to have lunch together, David, but as you heard President Biden tell me yesterday, he wants to go in there and lay down what these red lines are for Putin.
Cecilia Vega leading us off again tonight. Cecilia, thank you. Of course, the big question, how will the U.S. determine whether this summit is a success? Will they be able to get Vladimir Putin to change in any way to dial back his aggression? Let's bring in our Chief Global Affairs Anchor, Martha Raddatz, who's right here with us tonight. Martha, I know you've interviewed the Secretary of State on this. The Biden team is really trying to lower expectations. So how will they measure success coming out of this summit?
They sure are trying to lower expectations. And as you know, David, the reason they do that is any progress they make, they'll call some sort of a win. But Biden has had such tough talk this week. it will be very, very difficult to have anything like a deliverable that they're talking about. They will have their separate press conferences. They can spin it any way they want. But really, David, just lowering the temperature between the two men is a win.
Which Russia has signaled it wants as well.
Exactly.
All right, Mark Rath is right here with us all day tomorrow. The entire Powerhouse political team, our live coverage of the face-to-face meeting with President Biden and Vladimir Putin coverage all day tomorrow on ABC News. We're expecting it will begin right around 7 a.m. Eastern tomorrow morning. So we'll be right here ready to join our Good Morning America team. That moment begins tomorrow morning here on ABC.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the...